Well, that was quite a hard act to follow. It's my pleasure today to introduce an award-winning Australian artist who spent probably the last 25 years in almost every conflict around the world. Rwanda, Somalia, former Yugoslavia, Pakistan, Afghanistan. It's only a wonder he's not in Syria at the moment. He's been described as an anti-war artist, in contrast to the kind of artist who glorifies heroic deeds by combatants. And he's gone around setting up mobile studios inside conflict areas. We're going to see three videos from him and then have a chat with him. I ask you to welcome George Gittoes, please.
Yes.
Love City. We're about to rename Jalalabad. That's its true name. Love City.
Love City.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone.
This is Jalalabad, and I'm here with the help of my friends to make it the city of love and no more war.
There is no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything is from healing. Everything that traffic will allow.
By taking this banner through the streets of Jalalabad, we want to say war is over and to give love a chance. Yeah, I think to be an artist is to be an advocate of love. And, you know, the great poet Keats said, I just can't understand why people martyr themselves for religion. And then he thought a bit more and he thought, gee, I could martyr myself for love. And love is my religion. And I'm working with a bunch of great artists in Jalalabad who believe just that. And every one of them is prepared to die for love and to die for art. This started quite a long time ago when I heard that the Taliban were bombing DVD stores in Peshawar, and all my filmmaker artist friends asked me to come and help. And I made a film called Miscreants of Tallywood, but I also became a Pashtun actor. And I was the bad guy in the Pashtun movies. And the Taliban were attacking our film sets, and we went through floods and all these kinds of things. And then the artists of and filmmakers Jalalabad came down and said, gee, George, you've been helping these guys, you've made a whole lot of films, but it's worse for us in Jalalabad. You know that Jalalabad's the place where bin Laden launched 9/11. And, you know, all the video stores have been destroyed and we love art, can you come and help us? And actually, the first day that I got there, the last video store in Jalalabad was blown up. And I went and saw this shop owner, and he'd had his store blown up three times and tears were running down his face. And he said, I can't do it anymore, I've reopened with borrowed money. And so we bought a circus tent. So I'm now the ringmaster of the cinema circus of Jalalabad, and we're taking our films and our monkey and our clowns and our performers out as far as Tora Bora, places where the American forces have never been. Jalalabad's a strange city. I just read this terrible book, I think it's called The Long Day or something, by the soldier that went and shot bin Laden, a Navy SEAL. And all these guys, these special forces people and Americans and so on, are in this base in Jalalabad. That's where they sent the Black Hawks into Abbottabad to get bin Laden. And billions and billions of dollars are being spent on that. But quite often we'll have our circus out in a village And the American helicopters will be pounding a nearby village, just hitting it with rockets and missiles, and we'll be doing our art. And the interesting thing is that in the last 2 years that we've been bringing new films and an art to Jalalabad and creating a safe haven for the artists there, not one bad thing's happened. A lot of people said that we could never take the circus to Tora Bora because the Taliban were too much in control there. And I'm limping around at the moment because I went out there to check it out, and a guy had a stroke. And I gave him my car and I walked back from Tora Bora to Jalalabad. I felt safe enough to do that. And slipped on the way and damaged my knee. And when I came back, he said, the fact that you lent us a car just showed us that you were spontaneous and genuine. I'd never allow film or circus or anything like that, but I'll do it because we could see that you were genuine. And when we were there, we discovered that the kids had, like, the clothes that they wore were just thin cotton in the middle of winter. They had no school and they had nothing. You know, whenever we go there, we find children that need to go to hospital, they've got damaged eyes, and we get them off to hospital and things and save their eyes or their hands or whatever. And so just imagine this, this crazy old Australian with his long hair. I arrive in our blue circus truck and I've got my little monkey, Dali, and I saved Dali from a, he would have been a busker on the street. His mother was a busker. He had hundreds of tricks. And the children in the village have never seen a monkey before. So suddenly all the children come out and Dali starts doing his tricks. And always there's a couple of heavy Taliban types that don't want us to do our thing. But they're children amongst the ones that are watching the monkey. And then when Dali's done his tricks, he's got his own little hole into the tent. And he runs into the tent, takes all the children like he's the Pied Piper. They follow him in, and the sort of uptight sort of Taliban follow the children in. And then suddenly Dali does his ultimate trick. He climbs the circus pole and slides down like a little fireman. And he does this about three times, and then we've got everyone. We start doing our show. So I think as an artist who's covered war all my life, and I see a lot of very serious documentaries and things about the wars and conflicts and so on, but very few things give solutions. And what we're doing, for example, women can't go outside in Afghanistan, they're kept inside, and the men buy the videos and films. And we wanted to show them films where women were on top, women were winning, they were succeeding, they were running the show, and they're getting educated. So the way to do this was to make love story films. So our way into this culture was through our love films. And I discovered that every man, particularly every artist in Jalalabad had a love story, and they're all sad love stories. And so I discovered that although our project was based on the idea of love and not war, and that the military machine, that the military and the corporations and the politicians were into greed for power and profit, and that the artists were trying to create something beautiful, there was something else within that culture which has to change and is the real reason for the censorship of all the arts and things. So I'd like to just show a little bit of our film, which are a couple of the love stories that are in the films, the movies that we take out in the circus tent, and then we'll talk more about that. Have you heard the bad news?
No.
I've just got a whole lot of people sent me emails saying they've found the girl, but her arm's missing.
Oh, God.
Why?
This is the point.
دست
تاو که پایین دیگه کسای شما سای کو دختره کسای کو الگویس اگه یه چی گناه کده بیچاره
داده بشر دوانده سی چه ده خوی ده بشر ده بشر ده بشر خوی واضح ده خز بوده نده ولگی چه ده خز بشر خلق معلومه ده ما شما سه گری ده ما شما
One of the most talented actors in our group, Abed, volunteered to play the murdered girl's lover in our drama talk show.
داسې مده کې د خبرو اترو خبرونه لري
ما د دې ډیر خبرونه لیدلې
دا ډیر ناسمه ده ځوانان د دې لپاره وجل کیږي چې هغوی د یو بل سره مینه کوي آیا ته تیار یې چې زموږ خپرونې ته راشي او د دې کیسې په اړه څه خبرې وکړي
زه نور د بهللو لپاره هیڅ هم نه لرم
نو بیا د هغې واده وشو
هو ما د یو پټ ځینې د هغې د واده ننداره کوله د هغې په مخکې مخکې وې
The family of the promised husband went through with the wedding just to be able to get her into a car. The girl was dragged to a remote valley, still in her wedding dress.
بدرنګ کار بکیږي ما په زړه خوړلې وه سهار خبر شوم چې د هغوی کورنۍ ټوله شپه هم خوړنو کې لټولې وه هغوی نه ما پیدا کړې ما لټوله اول سړی زه وم چې د هغې مړی ما پیدا کړ
This because photographs have been found where she had her arm around her friend. In front of the cameras, Abed's grief was so real, he hadn't seemed like he was just acting. He went missing the next day. It was a few very worrying weeks before we knew why. Last time when you were filming, when we were filming inside, you were very emotional. And I thought, this guy either doesn't like me or he's the most worried man in the world.
I was told that I was a man who 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 was a man نامزاد یک ربل چاته اور کما جنې تی ویل اوس بس کیږي ਵਿਚار سکیږي ته از ما ژوند د ما زندگی زبا پښبو کې یو شمو دوه کال بعد ز دې دعوت کړم کور ته دو بجې را پاسې د روزه زم د مسلمانانو د سې چې روزې میاشتې روزه نیسو کله چې پلار او تاخ ترغه چې لورګانې پاسې پښنمی ته زیول دم وې د الک سوګ ده نو ما په کړکې ځان خطا کې ویل دم را پیسې ورم په کندغونی غوارو کې چې واري را باندې وکړ نو مور تل وار مکوا دلته په دې کور کې زما مینه ده زما ژوند دی زه زما نه ټلیفون نه وزه کې واغست زما د ورور ټلیفون ته ټلیفون راغی نو وایي دا وبید ته ورکړه چې ور مې که جینۍ ژړل وایي زه مې پلار ووهلم درې چاقو او کوټې راپسې قلف کړې نه مې مور پرېږدي نه خویندې نه ورونه او ډېر په بد حالت یم وباید څنګه چلو کړم مور تل چیغې ووهه کوم ګاونډي واوري نو ما نه ډېره نه تلې وس نشته د چیغو چې زه چیغه وهم درې چاقوان مې خوړلې ډېره نه رانه تلې ژاړي دومره ژاړي چې د حد نه زیات بیا زور دی زما د وس نه سنه کیږي زما خپم ماته ده ټلیفون نشته وس نشته په کوم رقم زه تا سره وګورم زما هیڅ
Sorry, I didn't mean to do that. Do you think it'll be possible to be together, ever?
No, ممکن نه ځکه هغه ورکړي ورکړي واده دی لس پنځه لس ورځې کې واده دی چې واده شي واده کړي چې نه خو زما سره ژوند نشي یو ځای کولی خو د داسې ملاقات امید لرم دا خیره کال میاشت لس کاله بعد مو د دې یو ورځ یا نیم ورځ یا یو ساعت نیم ساعت سره ملاقات شو د زړه خواله خو داسې د ژوند ملګرتیا نشو کولی ځکه اوس خبره ده خبرې نه تیره ده
So I believe that the most important freedom of expression is the freedom to love and to love the person that you fall in love with. And I think after all this time of working in Pakistan and Afghanistan, where it seemed that it was the Taliban that was crushing art and music and film and everything else, It's not the Taliban, it's the whole culture. It's a whole Pashtun culture where quite often the girl doesn't get to meet the man she's going to be married to. She's purchased, you know, like the families pay a lot of money and a lot of money is transpired. Quite often a wedding will have 2,000 people. Imagine the girl's never hardly been out of the house. She doesn't have to, she's not really allowed to walk in the street. She has to wear a burqa. And she's never been able to go to the movies or have a relationship with a young man. It's just always been within her own home. Usually she hasn't been educated. And that wedding night must be terrifying because she meets this guy for the first time and then she goes back and has to live with a lot of strange people. And we see in the news every night how often these girls are forced to become prostitutes or beaten or whatever because they don't like being in this position. And recently the government in Afghanistan has created new legislation. They're going backwards on what they're getting even worse than the Taliban. It's not possible for a woman, no matter how she's abused at home, to leave home. If she actually leaves home, it's a crime now in Afghanistan and she's in prison for it. And so this is a culture where I've realised that it's not just the Taliban, it's everyone who's stopping music, art, film, because what does music do? It encourages people to fall in love. What does film do, particularly the films we're making, encourages people to fall in love? And all the artists in our Yellow House Collective, most of them are young, and they love some girl. And this young man here, Osmar, is never going to be able to be with that girl. So this is more important, you know, the most important thing for all the artists at the Yellow House was to start making film, plays, writing, so that they can simply be with the person that they love. You know, in Norway and other countries, you hear about the problems for women in Afghanistan and tribal belt of Pakistan, but they're much more, it's much worse than you hear. In Jalalabad, for example, you cannot take a woman to a restaurant with you. The restaurants are only for men. So at the Yellow House, we've created the Secret Garden Cafe, and it's the only place in Jalalabad where men and women, you know, like young people, can actually sit together and talk and have a meal together. And then, like, my young assistant, Wakar, who shot all the movies with me, I've known him for 6 years now, and he's been to Australia 3 times to work with me. He's currently working with me. He's been to Norway. And I said, Wakar, don't you think your mother needs to meet me? You know, the man that you're working with who's taking you overseas. And he said, George, if I even suggested that to my mother, she would think I was insane. And so the women, not only are they stuck inside, his mother and his sisters never get to meet this interesting person who's working all over the world with him. The women are denied all of that. But so you can imagine how this affects the arts. Like, you can't go to a record store with a girl and pick the music you like. You can't go and see a band or hear a band. And any music which arouses people's emotion to fall in love is wrong. So it's not just the Taliban that's stopping this, the whole culture doesn't want it. And of course, some people are lucky. You know, the girl that's arranged for them, or the man that's arranged, it turns out it's good and love develops between them. But generally, you know, this is just not true. So while we're at the Yellow House and we're trying to create art and love and creativity, not war, the key thing for everyone there is to try and change the society and so that people who fall in love can be in love. So I'd just love to show you a little bit of the Yellow House. It's our solution. And this is the place where artists, and that's another form of censorship, not allowing artists to have a place where they can work and collaborate together. So I've funded the Yellow House out of my own money, and along with Hellen, and we've opened the doors and we've created this sanctuary for artists. And here's just a little bit of the creative explosion that's going on there.
1, 2, 3, 4.
After years of repression, the Yellow House has opened its gates and artists are coming from everywhere to help.
Oh.
I'm very lucky.
Don't
because
forget it.
I'm very in love, and I've got the person that I love with me at the Yellow House, and you know this is this is it. That's Hellen.
Yeah, this is about the power of love. Very simple thing, and creativity, and providing a space, a sanctuary. Yesterday, people were talking about going out. Boal. Anyway, going out and taking it to people, creating a sanctuary in Cape Town for the lesbian women there. You know, uniting, joining the freedom fighters in the world that are laying their lives down. Europe joining with Afghanistan, declaring art on war. That's what we want to do. Had to get that one out.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Hellen Rose, performance artist and singer and co-founder of the Yellow House in Jalalabad. And I'm really, really sorry, but we're at the end of our time. We hope to have a kind of quick chat with them, but I think you're going to have to do it in the coffee break.
Okay.
Really apologize.
Love
we're right
power.
Out of
time. L-O-V-E. Woo! Yeah!